Good afternoon. I'm pleased to give this presentation on enhancing the integration of in-situ Atlantic observation data and services to users. This is the result of the collaborative work between partners in AtlantOS that I want to thank today. So I will go through the presentation of the European data system that we wanted to target in within the AtlantOS project, and on the key achievements that have on enhancing data integration and services to users. The integrated data system doesn't start from scratch, but is built on existing systems, and it goes from a starting point 3 years ago when the project started, and with a target, with the goal to enhance data integration and to serve the users better. So what are the existing systems that were involved in this project? On one side, we have diverse in-situ observing networks active in the Atlantic Ocean. Networks are defined as so because they are platform-oriented, because their data systems are organized to provide homogeneous data processed according to common standards in terms of quality control, metadata, and formats. And finally, networks also is access to their data. So within the AtlantOS project, it gathers networks from chip-based observation networks, autonomous observing systems, and coastal observing systems. On the other side, we have the systems of European integrators. An integrator aggregates data from various networks, data centers, and platform operators to provide an integrated thematic service to users. And it checks consistency of the essential ocean variables in time and space in order to provide easy-to-use specific products to end users. So within the AtlantOS project, it involves six integrators, being either infrastructures like Copernicus, CDataNet, and ICES on Eurobis, and also portals that are EdModel Vlots and Geos portal. So in that data landscape of existing system, at the beginning of the project, we analyzed the situation and found out that there was a lack of harmonization across existing systems. For in-situ connection, for connection of observations to the integrators, that was done through ad hoc interfaces, for lack of common identification for platform, institution, and parameters, and not commonly agreed near real-time procedures across the systems. So this was causing duplications of efforts among the actors, a risk of mixing apples and oranges for users, also difficulty in tracing data usage, and probably underuse of existing data services. Consequently, to ensure that in-situ data are readily accessible and usable to the wider community, the partners have chosen not to build a new system, but to enhance the existing system at every level of the data flow, from the networks to the integrators, that is, from the acquisition of the data to the services to users. So, in this context, as where we do not reinvent the wheel, we simply chosen to grease the works properly in order to ingest and deliver greater data, and to serve the users better in a more harmonized way. So to do so, the partners firstly agreed on a minimum set of recommendations for the purpose of harmonization across the systems. Then both the networks and the integrators start to implement these recommendations and also to implement the tool from the data exchange backbone that will ease discovery, viewing, and downloading by the users. So all the partners have entered a continuous improvement loop that will continue even after the project will end. And I'm a bit lost. So it will continue after the end of the project. The Atlantos project is only a starting point in this announcement. So let's look now at the achievements on enhancing data integration. Firstly, for harmonization purposes across data systems, the partners are implementing the minimum set of common metadata recommended. This set is relying on existing standards, mostly from CDataNet. It includes a common and unique identification for platforms and institutions, and also a common vocabulary for essential variables that has been defined within the project and that is mapped to the recommended vocabularies from CDataNet and Worms for Spaces. Then, for a core of essential variables measured by more than one network, the quality control procedures for data acquired in near real time are implemented or enhanced to fulfill the recommended procedures. All the recommendations are well documented and have got a DOI. And for the QC, for the near real time QC, they will evolve under the Yorgos umbrella within the years after the, even if the Atlantos project will end next year. Then, by enhancing interoperability between systems, the goal is to ingest and deliver more greater data to the users. So, firstly, the networks. There was an enhanced access to the network data by setting a unique entry point to discover and download existing data. Major advances have already been achieved or are well underway. One of these major advances is the setup of a new GDAC for drifters that will ease the data access for NRT data and best copy of selection of GM data. Then on the integrator side, there are also big improvement in ingestion of network data. And one important result is, for example, the setting of new nodes for CDataNet or direct GDAT flow to CDataNet. And finally, thanks to an enhanced monitoring facility provided by GCOMOPS, it also enhanced the validation of the integration of data to ensure that we get the most data in this integrated system. For the last part of my presentation, I will show the central services that have been set up to better serve the users. The first one is the AtlantOS catalog that enables to discover and facilitate the access to data services. Then there are two monitoring services that have been designed during the AtlantOS project. And the most recent one is a traceability service to give visibility of data usage. So first, the AtlantOS catalog intends to describe what are the elements of the integrity data system and to provide the users with a discovery service of the elements of the system and their services. So it enables with simple filters on on the elements of the integrated system and the essential variables to browse through the entries of this catalog. For example, if a user wants to know which are the networks that handle carbonate system data, they will use the interface of this catalog by selecting networks and carbonate system, and they will the tool will display the entries in the catalog, answering to his search. Then this catalog aims to facilitate access to data services. First, to viewing services. When WMS services exist in the catalog entries, the user can display the different data layers in the map facility of the tool. And the same for downloading, when there is a FTP download services associated to an element, it can be accessed directly from the catalog entry. And finally, it's also possible to access to more resources through external web links available in the catalog entries. For example, this is the Ego Gliders network. And you can access to the Ego website or to the main manuals for the data users. Also, we want, of course, that this tool is sustained after the end of the projects. This is already achieved through the GEOS portal that have brokered all the entries from the catalog in its system. And this is on the way for Orgus. Then there are the two services, two monitoring services developed within the AtlantOS project. The European one, which aims to track from the user side, which is set up in the Orgus website, and the international one, which aims to track the implementation of networks developed by GCOMOPS. Then the most recent service is the traceability service on data usage. We have diversity among the services for discovery, download, viewing, and DOI, and so on. But still, maintaining a common set of minimal tracking information is possible, and they can be shared to compute user statistics in an integrated traceability service. It is based on a shared common format among the partners. So it will provide a web interactive dashboard which will display core statistics giving visibility of data usage to data providers and to system managers. It is a joint development of IFREMER, ATT, and GCOMOPS. The initial version, which includes the FTP download, will be available by the end of this year, and the later versions will include the other kind of services, data services, like HTTP, WMS, and so on. So this is the example of Argo FTP downloads in 2017. In conclusion, we have designed within the AtlantOS project an enhanced system, but which is based on existing infrastructures and that will run even after the end of the AtlantOS project has ended. Implementation has started within the project and will continue in the framework of other projects. Thank you for your attention.